Hate is a strong word, but there's a certain feeling I get in my body whenever I'm signing up for a website and they start asking me personal questions like, what's your first pet's name? What's your elementary school? What's your mother's maiden name? What city were you born in? And it doesn't happen as often these days, but it still happens. And whenever it does, there's that security bone inside of me that gets kinda nervous, because it's just not very secure. These are what we begrudgingly call security questions, or sometimes referred to as secret questions, and they were primarily used in the past, oftentimes as an account recovery option. So, like if you forgot your password, oh no, my password, they would ask you a bunch of personal questions, and if you could answer all of them, you'd be all set. But there's a lot of problems with this, centered around the theme of being neither secret nor secure. First and foremost, all of these questions are actually not that secret. Like, what's your first pet's name? Are you serious? I talk about my pets all the time, so it's very concerning to me when these sites give me the option to choose father's name as an appropriate secret question. As I was writing this script, I was asked to create an account with that as a potential security question. So anyone who knows me at all, or you know, knows how to do a quick Google search, can find out a lot of this information without too much of a struggle. But even if you knew nothing about a person, and I don't know, we're just too lazy to do a quick social media search to break into an account, these questions aren't particularly varied in their answers either. Like, let's talk about city you were born in or city you first lived in. Like, let's say I know you live in the United States and that's the only thing I know about you. Turns out, there's an 8% chance you live in one of these 10 cities, which means 8% of the time, I'm gonna be able to guess these answers within 10 tries. This becomes even more extreme in certain other areas. If I know you live in Japan, there's an 11% chance you live in Tokyo. First try, 11% of accounts are compromised. If I know you live in Korea, there's a 19% chance that you live in Seoul. So that means, this question, if I have one guess, almost 1 in 5 of you have the same answer. Same goes with questions like last names or favorite food, depending on your language or culture, these questions might have a far lower variability than you should be comfortable with. Like a randomly generated 8-digit password has quadrillions of possible values, but the model of your first car? There's not that many kinds of cars. If everyone on the planet right now decided to design and build 1,000 different models of cars, it still wouldn't even be close. So why do websites even do security questions? Well, supposedly, it's a question that people will remember for their entire lives because it's fundamental to them and will never change. This also happens to be its primary weakness. Like, if it never changes, that means unlike a password, if it leaks once, it's insecure forever. Or, you know, if you post something on social media once, it's insecure. I mean, have you ever told anyone your dad's first name? Insecure. And also, that means it's going to be the same value for every single site you use it for. You know, exactly the opposite of what we expect a good password to look like. But also, sometimes they ask questions that do change, like what's your favorite food or your favorite superhero? Then you gotta think back to when you were 13 and made that account and think, huh, what would 13-year-old me say is their favorite food? Funnily enough, what a handful of people do is that they make up an answer and try to make it harder to guess, or sometimes easier to remember. But also sometimes it just has the opposite effect because you forgot what your fake answer was, which is a pain. So what I like to do is generate basically a second password and store it in my password manager or key vault, but it's not like a lot of password managers have slots for you to input 2 passwords, so I gotta figure out how to make like a secure note or something. It's a whole thing. It's a pain. Whatever. And yeah, other methods of authentication can be a pain too. Like, 2-factor authentication becomes pretty difficult if you lose your phone. But just my opinion, I have a password manager, I have my 2-factor, and if I never have to see another poor security question again, I'll be pretty happy. Alright, video over. Click away if you want. I just wanted to let you know that this last month and a half-ish has been absolutely wild. I have been in the process of quitting one job, applying to all sorts of places, onboarding onto another job, living on my floor, moving across the country, trying to find an apartment, all while trying to make this video without any of my equipment, my computer, desk and chair, my mic, my assets, all that. And I'm just so glad I was able to scrape together this video with my scuffed setup. You may have noticed that the last few videos have been a little shorter, but I wanted to put something out because I'm so grateful for the support of this channel the past few months. It's been so chaotic around here, but my viewers, especially my Patreon supporters, are so wonderful. I needed to put something out there. When I got all my stuff back, we'll be sure to have the proper credits and everything, but please excuse our appearances for the time being, and thank you so much for the support. If you'd like to join them, link to my Patreon is in the description. Again, apologies for the somewhat scuffed videos. Hopefully, we'll be up and running soon.